The very first thing I'm thinking is the scene secure?
A paramedic for 22 years, Don Walker has a mental checklist for nearly every emergency.
The next thing we're thinking is, where on the body is the person wounded? Is it a single shot or is it more than one?
He's got his routine for treating gunshot victims, even though the wounds themselves are never routine.
Each bullet will do something different inside of different people. Some will cause more damage than others. They are completely unpredictable.
During an average year in Massachusetts, gun violence kills 257 people and injures 648. Nationally, it's the leading cause of death for children and teens ages 1 to 19.
These are absolutely preventable injuries.
Dr. Eric Fliegler is a pediatrician in the emergency room at Mass General Hospital and a senior researcher for the hospital's Gun Violence Prevention Center.
We need to think not only just about the guns, but the bullets themselves.
Dr. Fliegler's latest study uses ballistic gel to mimic human tissue.
These are the videos that kind of really give us a sense of what's happening inside the body.
The first, a .38 caliber bullet shot from a handgun.
It's almost like a knife that had gone through, and you see a cavity from the ripping of the tissue that happens. But the damage itself is fairly focal. It's around the path of the bullet itself.
And now a larger NATO bullet shot from an AR-15.
It's like a shockwave. It's going to cause damage further away from where the bullet itself went in. So imagine that bullet has gone through the abdominal cavity. It's not just going to cause the small path that the bullet traverses, but it's going to damage and rip into the aorta, the liver, the spleen, the lungs, the heart. The organs that are further away from the actual bullet tracing itself, they get fully damaged by these very powerful bullets.
For most pediatric patients, the prognosis is grim.
Damage is going to be so severe that even the children who survive are going to be severely injured the rest of their life. And the majority of these children, unfortunately, will not survive.
Dr. Fliegler would like to see legislation that targets bullets by limiting the type and amount that people can buy.
I will say, the first time I watched the video, I was totally shocked. These are things that don't have to happen. These are all preventable. But the more they happen, the more we get used to it.
The American Academy of Pediatrics estimates about one-third of children in the U.S. live in homes with guns, and research shows even toddlers are strong enough to pull a trigger. In the newsroom, I'm Jessica Brown, WCVB News Center 5.